All right.
We got another song coming for you, beautiful people.
I don't know. Was this...
Oh my God, let's go. I'm Ben.
I'm sorry.
If you would like to get your song reviewed, dear listener, there's the Filthy Capitalist option. As Sori says, 125 gets you straight to the head of the line. You don't have to be a part of the alliance. You don't have to be part of the group.
Wait a minute.
And the biggest thing is you don't have to wait. You hop, skip, and jump right in front of everybody. 125 gets you there. You do that 3 times and then get mashed down to the $75 rate for perpetuity.
Yes!
Also, there is a band review option. So if you've got a band and you're trying to get your band some exposure, hit me up at itsori@gmail.com and I'll show you the details about how to pull
you
that off.
You can also jump on Patreon and there is a option on the tiers to be able to get your band reviewed. Yep. Obviously, we can't lie to you, so we can't guarantee,
a positive review.
Get what you get.
It's just rubbish.
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 That's British for garbage.
My favorite is the community option. $1 at the gate gets you into Patreon. You get to join an alliance. The alliance joins their points together, and that helps determine what songs that we do.
The alliances hang out on Discord.
Message me on Patreon to get the link.
And they do all kinds of other cool things. They do Minecraft. What? Dungeons and Dragons.
Yeah, yeah. It's really a community within the community. Anybody can go in the village, facebook.com/BenAndSori. There's 160 plus thousand people on the channel. What's cool about the Discord is that it offers a real opportunity for community, connection, friendship, that type of thing.
But, and it's on Discord, so if you're not a Facebook person, it's for you.
You start off at $1.
Right.
Plus you get exclusives. Sori and I are working on a song. So the first 15 seconds of that was on Patreon. Also, at $15 tier and above, when we actually debut the video, they're going to be there live with us. There you are, dear listener.
Buy our merch.
It's longer than I expected here.
Child shall lead them. Don't worry about it.
Buy our merch.
We have come to the end, my friends.
But it's not really the end because we still have an entire review to do.
Don't get sad.
Stamina, Kadanet Kulmi Sana. This is Kai. Kai picked this song. It's Stamina. Okay, so Kai is the one that's doing our DJ stream tonight.
Yes, sir. Shout out to Long Live
Finland.
Kai.
See, that's the flag of Finland. I presume. The song that we're doing here, he said he first fell, it's a prog thrash metal band, and he first fell in love with their guitar, their great guitar riffs, and then he fell in love with their lyrics. So I'm not going to start reading the lyrics because we'll see that in the song. So that's it. That's all he wanted to say.
All right, dear listener, here we go. Stamina. I don't know how to pronounce the name of the song, but...
Nor do we know what it means.
But I'm sure Kai will translate as he comments throughout. Here we go, guys! Let's go! take me.
Interesting song, like rap, hell? Finish, thrash, heavy.
Internal Fire says, name of the song, please.
Oh, we can put that up.
It says, disappeared, three words. I hate you, human. Maybe I hate you, human is three words in Finnish language. Because it's probably hate, yeah, in the possessive form.
Hate and
form.
You probably go together, yeah.
It's probably right. Hate in the possessive form.
Right.
Which would translate to I hate. But it's one word because they're probably a little bit more efficient.
Oh, see I see. Saying? I hate go together.
So, yeah, hate you, human is probably the three words, but holy smokes.
Put this one up.
What's the name of that song? Ramon says, loved it. Great way to finish the show. He put one N and two I's, though.
Well, you
know. You fucked up, buddy. You should have put two N's.
Yeah,
gotta...
but, I mean, who's counting?
It's the Finnish version of Mudvayne. That's true. Like, the way that they were doing the chorus lines, I mean, the verse lines.
Yeah.
Yeah, that was like Mudvayne.
Oh, that was yeah. Like okay.
For sure. Like.
There it is. There's the name of the song. I just put it out there for you.
Oh, where is it?
Stamina.
Oh, there it goes. Okay. So this is the name of the, yeah, right there. I was right. Three words. I hate you, human. Vihaan sinua himinin. Which, yeah, so I was right. Vihaan is
shoot, you word. Know, we should do that every time. I should put it in the thing and you post it on there so people can know what the name of the song is.
Yeah, well, people were pretty much doing that, like, the entire time.
Okay, excellent.
a lot of the verses that you do are kind of like generic, and a lot of times it's just you're waiting to get to the chorus.
Mm-hmm.
But the verse lines were so unique, like the way that he did it, the rhythm, the cadence, and the way that he did it. It was somebody was like, "Yo, is he rapping? Is this Mudvayne?" Like, I love when bands like pay attention to that. We kind of have that because like the first verse and the second verse are completely different in our song, so we kind of have that. But like. The way that they did the verse lines were so unique. Like, I'm just going to play that part again. Hopefully we don't get blocked. People are like, yeah, you're going to get blocked. But inshallah, we don't get blocked. But, what was the name of the band again?
It's called Stamina.
Oh, yeah, Stamina. Yeah, Stamina. Oh, sorry. That's a one, bro. Not an I. All right, there you go. Yeah, it's just like really, you know, like very, very unique verse line.
You know, there's like that. It's kind of a country sounding thing, and it kind of goes. That in songs.
Yeah.
Like it sounded like he was trying to make his voice sound like that instrument.
Yeah, the cadence was really, really cool. It's really, really cool. Now I'm gonna try to. And I gotta say, the previous band was like a thrash band, so I was like, all right, I'm ready to rock. I'm ready to get violent.
And then there was no, like, violence. I was like, when I say violent, I mean, like, heavy.
Oh, so boy. Scary.
I was a little bit disappointed. But then, of course, you know, hearing the actual lyrics, it was very inspired. But this one, I'm very, very glad that we ended with some.
Yeah.
See, Kai knows me. He's like, I got to get my brother some. I got to get my brother some heaviness here because, you know, he knows how I am. Okay, so.
Disappeared three words. Yeah. My life spring like total madness. I walk under the morning sky, eyes blind, feet in winds, and heartbeats 200. I had to. I changed to direction. I come back on the traces of my path. Now I have to hurry. Day rises after all. Now I know what to say. In my mind's landscapes, only landmarks is the deep scars that I left. I run and I try to head home, but I walk across again, lost boy. Melting, feeling becoming ice again. Bad words and steps are heavy. In black and white world, I still want to return and shout. I hate you, human. I traced it. I traced the disappeared sentence. I hate you, human. Disappeared three words. It was about time to change directions. Should I keep going?
Yeah, I've got the lyrics here.
Deadlocked is the door. Threshold has been crossed for the last time. All is last winter snows slowly disappear to the four winds. Day turns to evening. I turn backwards and make fire because my feet are still cold and not for long. Not a single step more. No words. I don't find any reason to run away. If truth doesn't burn in the fire, my coming back was right and speech useless. I hate you, human. I traced it. I traced the disappeared sentence. I hate you, human. Disappeared three words. It was about time to change directions. I hate you, human. I don't lack anything. We'll go with these. Nothing will change. I hate you, human. And then it just keeps repeating that. The last thing is, I hate you, human. Disappeared three words. No longer intend to change direction.
I don't lack anything. We'll go with these. Nothing will change. I hate you, human. Disappeared three words. I no longer intend to change direction.
Yeah, that was repeated multiple.
So which human does he hate? Does he hate himself? Does he hate his past self? Does he make decisions that he made? See, look. Sori could narrate the beginning of some sci-fi fantasy movie easily. I could come. Thank you. Just your wait. Maybe she will.
You never know. Yeah, I guess. I don't know. I don't know if it's because, again, you know how. Oh, you guys are going to hate me. Star Trek, that the guy with the ears, the green guy, his ears go out. He's like a very old.
Is a green guy? And Star Trek?
Maybe it's Star Wars. It's probably Star Wars.
Yoda.
You know, he'll like say a sentence like here and then he backs it up.
Yeah. You never got out, you did.
Right.
Yeah.
Stuff like that. So when I'm reading this, like my mind has to like do that because in Finnish they must flip their sentences like that. So I'm not sure if he hates himself or if there's someone else that he hates, which is why he hasn't been home.
Or maybe it's literal and he hates humanity. You know what I'm saying? Maybe
it's yeah, but he says, in my mind, landscapes only landmarks is the deep scars that I left. And I run and I try to head home, but I walked across, but I walked crossed again, lost boy. So it seems like he left home and he decides he's going to go back. And so I'm not sure if he hates himself or if he hates the person that made life so miserable that he left. And yeah. I don't know what the disappeared sentence is.
The disappeared sentence is, I hate you, human.
Okay, so maybe that was said to him.
Disappeared three word, disappeared sentence seems to be the same thing.
Deadlocked is the door. Threshold has been crossed for the last time.
This one is kind of ethereal, so you could kind of go anywhere with it. But he says, in the deep scars that I left, I run and try to head home. And then he says, but I walk across again, lost boy.
Yeah, that's why. So that's why I think he's returning home.
Childhood type of situation.
Yeah, and he says, but I don't find any reason to run away at the end. You know, like he's. So I think he goes back, but there's no reason to run now, but there might not be a reason to stay either.
I don't find any reason to run away if truth doesn't burn in the fire. My coming back was right and my speech was useless.
So the I hate you human was useless?
Well, his running away and him taking a stand won't mean anything if truth doesn't burn in the fire, in the sense that if the truth becomes self-evident and then everybody realizes the truth, which I'm assuming caused him to run away in the first place and make him this angry person, then everybody finally ended up seeing it. Mm-hmm. And a lot of times, like, people will do all these dramatic things to expose the truth.
Yep.
Because, you know, and it's interesting in that movie that we just
watched. Yeah, Daniel, I was thinking the same thing.
What?
Prodigal Son.
Yeah, I don't know, though, because the Prodigal Son was a kid in a good situation that was an entitled, spoiled mm-hmm. brat.
Yeah, just like, the coming home part.
That's but... not the same thing. You know what I'm saying? Like, mm-hmm. it doesn't look like he was an entitled, spoiled brat. It looks like there's some horribleness happening.
Well, yeah, where he says, was. In my mind's landscapes, only landmarks is the deep scars. In other words, he's saying when he remembers back, the only landmarks that are there, it's not like, oh, there was this tree. There was what happened at that tree. There was what happened at. So all of it is, right. it's his scars and the memories that are connected to those things. So he doesn't just see the land for what it is.
Right.
He sees all the pain that. Yeah. That place caused.
Right. So I wouldn't say that that's a prodigal son situation. I'd say the family system is.
Yeah, the prodigal it was just the situation. Coming back home.
Yeah, but he can't go back home. That's why he says lost boy. Home it says gone. I tried to head home.
Yeah.
He didn't say he's coming home. He's trying to get home, but he walks crossed again, and then he's a lost boy.
Yeah.
So there is a sense in which even if your childhood is bad and traumatic, it still counts as your childhood. Mm-hmm. And kids are very good at finding ways to play and have fun and be kids even when the adults have completely failed them. Now, I was in a situation where yeah. I'd say the adults completely yeah. failed me, but I remember being in a homeless shelter. And I remember spending Christmas in a homeless shelter. And I know people going like, oh my God, poor Vinny spent Christmas in a homeless shelter. I had fun. The people bought us presents. I was racing my remote control car all over the place. It's very inconvenient to have to move every week.
Did you guys have to get up real early too? Like,
I mean, we had to go to school. You know what I'm saying? So, you know, it's one of those things. Like, you were pretty much out before you had to go to school anyway. So, but like, I didn't have a hard time there. We had mm-hmm. sock and bop. We had this thing called sock and boppers, which was basically blow up like balloon hands, and we got to box each other. And then we had remote control cars, and in one of my stops, there was like a bath. We were like literally in a gym. We were in a gym at some private school, and that's where we were for about a week. It was like a little tent city in the gym. We got to play basketball. Yeah,
I know. You talked about that. I think that ego causes so much suffering for people because, you know, like you have one brother that just calls it the S.
Yeah.
To this day.
Yeah.
And the other brother yeah. didn't. Won't put that out there. And, but here you come. We were in a homeless shelter, blah, blah, blah. It doesn't affect you. And I think, honestly, how much of our suffering is unnecessary? Like, how much suffering do we experience simply because our ego is so big?
And we're looking at, well, yeah, there's ego.
Because separate. Like you said, your family was together. You're with your mom, you're with your brothers. It's not like you guys were separated. That would cause some pain,
well, the
you know?
Thing is, myself and my older brother had the opportunity to get out of there. My dad showed up.
Right.
And says, you know, basically, no kid of mine is going to be in some shelter. He's like, I'll take you guys right now. And I wasn't going to leave my mom and my little brother in that situation. Like, that was not going to happen. Like, no.
This guy, even, what, you were six? How old were you?
No, I wasn't six. I was in, like, the seventh grade, eighth grade.
Codes at such a young age.
No, my older brother was the exact mm-hmm. same way. Like, we were never, but, like, that's my mom. Like, I'm not going to leave. We're not, I think most people are like that. Most people, you're not going to leave your mom and your little brother to go live. Get out of here. Like, that's all we knew. That's the only family we knew. We were never going to do that. But my point is, like, so even as a child, like, you can be in adverse circumstances as a kid and still eke out little air pockets of, like, oh, nostalgia and whatever. So he's trying to go back home, but the... And you could say it's ego. The other side of it, I was listening to this thing about stoicism, and it was a very fascinating thing because I think I agree with this. And he said a lot of our suffering, or a lot of our suffering in our memories anyway, is the significance we assign to the situation.
Oh, it's true.
So, I mean, that could be ego-driven, but a lot of that could be societally driven. Like, so for example, society is like, oh my God, you're in a homeless shelter on Christmas. We're also there on Thanksgiving. Now that I think about it. Oh, you spent the holidays in a homeless shelter. And so that's American society. That's a narrative that they put on top of that situation. And if I would have, I don't know if it was bought into it. I don't know what the term is because I've never struggled with that. You know what I'm saying? So
you and Johan.
But if I would have adopted that, when I look back at it, there would be all this emotional angst and all the rest of it. You know what I'm saying? And there are things in my family that and there are moments and things like that that do cause me a lot of emotional duress and angst. Mm-hmm. And that's where I probably disagree with stoicism in a sense, because I do think there are things that are objectively bad, mm-hmm. regardless of what narrative you put on top of it. But I think a lot of pain can be saved, because I think a lot of what we think is objectively bad really isn't. It's just what society is telling you the story. Because if you take somebody from a lower caste colony in India and you tell them, hey, when it got cold, I had 3 meals a day. People brought me presents.
Absolutely.
When I went to shower, now there's sometimes you had to go to YMCA and take a shower. That was inconvenient. I'm not going to lie about that. That was inconvenient. But there were other times when they had the shower right there. It was, 7 degrees outside, but the water was 75. If I would have laid all that out to a kid in a low caste system in India, they would say, oh, you must be a Brahmin. No, you live like a king. Mm-hmm. You see what I'm saying?
Yeah.
So their narrative about that kind of situation would be that I was at the top of the world. Mm-hmm. You see what I'm saying? And if I would have, and here's the crazy thing. Because the Brahmin in their caste system is at the top. And a lot of them are arrogant, very prideful, look down on people, literally will not touch people who are literally beneath them, societally speaking. So if I were to adopt that lower caste person's, that untouchable caste, if I were to adopt his narrative on my experience, I would look down on people for living in a homeless shelter. Mm-hmm. Because the fact of the matter is, he would say, everybody is serving you. Mm-hmm. The Jewish synagogue, they opened their doors. They served you. They served you food. You used their heat. You used their showers. They served you. And so their narrative would be that I was this king and everybody was serving me. And if I adopted that, I would be bragging to people telling them I was in a homeless shelter. Mm-hmm. So which I think is just as bad as being traumatized that you were in a homeless shelter. A lot of our past is like that. Now, that's why I'm saying there are things that are objectively bad. Like if you had serious abuse, you had sexual abuse, if you had misconduct, those are things that are objectively bad. I don't give a fuck what story you put on it. It was bad. Mm-hmm. And you probably need therapy and you should go. But, there's a lot of other things that are just societally placed on you. And depending on where you are and what time period you're in your society, you're either going to be traumatized or you're going to be mega arrogant. Not realizing that we're all pretty much in the same place, if you really, really think about it. And then it turns you into a person who hates humanity. If you dwell on that shit.
Oh, for sure.
So that's the takeaway for me, is how much of your past trauma is based on your ego, an incomplete story, or a societal narrative that's placed on you? Because those three things can make you look back at your past and you can genuinely feel that you can genuinely adopt society's negative feeling about something that you're completely good with.
Yep.
And that's why sometimes you're you're so weird, you're in a homeless shelter, you don't feel shame or whatever, whatever, whatever. And it's because I don't, for whatever reason, I don't adopt society's take, American society's take on what a homeless shelter is and what it means about me as a person or whatever. But honestly, it's your ego, an incomplete memory, or a societal, push on you. That changes things. But yeah, I love this song because it was heavy, and my brother Kai knows that I love the heavy shit, so he waited till the end to give me the heavy song.
Yeah, and the video was fun too.
Yeah, it was very, very fun. Very, yep. Very, very, very fun. What do you get this song?
This one is, it's high.
I know.
I'm debating between 9.8, a 9.9, and a 10.
Okay, here's why it's going to get a 10 for me. Because of how unique that chorus line was.
Oh, I forgot.
I cannot get over that because it makes a song complete.
Yep, and the way that he did the vocals, that was also unique. Yeah, it's a 10.
There was no, like, okay, I'm what? There's a lot of songs. Like I said, especially at the first part, you're just, okay, I'm going to get through the verse, to get to the chorus, to get to the solo, to get to the middle, amazing breakdown. Sometimes you have a melody line that is so powerful that it carries the entire song.
Yep.
But other times, like, there's you can stop the song at any point and say, where's the weakness? This song was like probably one of the most complete songs I've heard this year. There's no weakness in the song. There's no waiting to get to the chorus.
That's good. Yeah. So, there's no weakness in it. Yeah. That's good.
Freaking A, Kai, 10. Man.
Yeah.
Every single song here is
we've
a
got
band.
Actually
Black
a lot of people giving it. I was just gonna, 10. We've got DJ Mike Franco gives it a 10. We've got Brandon Lewis giving it a 10. Daniel Smith giving 9.5, Black Satan 10. It was definitely well liked. It was well received.
Yeah, and Mike said he's never heard a vocalist like that. I could call.
Yeah, totally. Well, thank you for this stream, Kai.
Holy shit, Kai. Really, really good.
I wasn't sure how it was going to go because you don't really know what to expect when it's going to be finished, you know?
Yeah, like you don't. Yeah, shout out to Finland who's produced some really great artists with a lot of freaking range, dude. Mm-hmm. A lot of freaking range. So long live Finland. Shout out to Finland. Finland, you guys we got to give Finland some love.
Some love from Maine.
Gang. Do it again for Finland. And the best thing about Finland, obviously, is my brother Kai. Shout out to the big homie Kai. Yes, sir, Robert. We got another. Do we have another DJ stream scheduled tomorrow?
We do.
Another DJ stream scheduled tomorrow.
Tomorrow
y'all.
Is Middle Earth.
Yes. Okay. Good.
One,
so we got
two,
a,
three, four,
the
five,
Middle
five,
Earth
six,
stream seven. Coming tomorrow, and then we got another stream after that, y'all. So we got streams coming back to back.
Yeah, and we're going to be going to a concert if it doesn't get canceled. So that'll be it's an Evanescence concert. So
yes, sir. Amy Lee Forever. Yep. Cannot wait for that.
Yep.
The Beatles stream. Inshallah. All right, guys. We're out of here. Take care of each other. Love your neighbor. Take care of each other. Long live freaking Finland and live longer, Kai. We are out of here. Vin out. I want the guy to live longer than the country.
I was like, wait, does that mean the country would fail early? Because he can only last so long.
Well, he goes on 10, 11 right there.
Oh, yep.
If I love the guy, then
he should
live longer.
And the rest of the country can just... Ridiculous. Bye, guys.
Kitos. I don't know how to pronounce that properly. It means goodbye or I love you or whatever. Whatever it is. Kitos to Kai. Kitos to Finland, long live Finland, longer live Kai. Vin out.